Let us begin the Harvest Money Show on Urban TV by exploring one of the most prominent ventures embraced by poultry farmers in Uganda, the commercial production of eggs through raising egg-laying birds. These birds typically start laying eggs for commercial purposes at around 18 to 19 weeks of age and continue doing so until they reach approximately 72 to 78 weeks old. Nantambi Christine, the managing director of Stina Enterprises Limited, has established herself as a seasoned businesswoman. However, she has now achieved great success as a skilled poultry farmer operating a state-of-the-art modern demonstration farm in Bweya Kajansi Town Council, Wakiso District. Our quest for the Vision Group Best Farmer 2023 led us to visit her farm and conduct an interview. During our conversation, she shared her remarkable journey of transitioning from a businesswoman to a thriving poultry farmer. Let us delve into her inspiring story without further delay.
Started poultry farming from nowhere. I'm not a trained agri person. I didn't do agriculture. I didn't train in agriculture, but I'm a business lady. My background of being a business lady, I'm a trainer, I'm a consultant. I think being in the business development area, I interacted more with people who are in agriculture. And then I think I tended to develop my interest. When you discover your passion early, what you want to do. So from the beginning, when I ventured, let me just start chicken. I'm using the word just. Kangezeko, let me just start chicken to get some income. I found that just meant a lot in my life. It was not just doing poultry. It was something I enjoyed doing. So I came to understand starting chicken because I had learned it was just starting. I found that it was my passion of doing.
Nantambi specializes in raising layer birds, a unique breed of hens that require dedicated care from their first day of life. Upon bringing these chicks into the shelter, they demand utmost attention and care. Providing a suitable brooder is essential, ensuring they receive sufficient warmth during their initial 2 months. In our interview with Nantambi, she elaborated on the crucial requirements for anyone aspiring to start a farm, along with the valuable insights on farm management.
Poultry needs a lot of capital. If you're focusing on large scale, you need to construct buildings. If you're to go in cages, one cage costs around 1,300,000. A structure itself can cost like a certain million. So sometimes I try to advise people, start slowly and grow. You can start in an automated depleter system, which is slightly cheaper, and then you grow into cages. So you can, if you really want to start poultry, you can, with your 2,000 birds, you need around 50 million for only working capital without buildings and equipment. If you're interested, you need to book your chicks in a well-known incubating place. There are many in Kampala, but you need to do research. I know you will find many people selling all day chicks in Container Village. I wouldn't advise you to just go and buy. First, understand which company is doing it, because sometimes you may end up buying not good chicks. So after doing research on where you're going to buy your chicks, book your chicks. It takes like 1 month for you to get those chicks, because chicks come out after 21 days. So it takes you like 1 month. So within that 1 month, as you prepare to get your chicks. Prepare yourself. Prepare your brooding area. Make it well with needed equipment. Those are the brooding heaters, like pots, like sigiris, like lamps, depending on what you want. Then put feeders and eaters in your brooder. So that day you're expecting the birds, warm the brooder and put water and food. So when you bring in that, the chicks will find when the place is warm, they'll find when there is water, and then you put your chicks there. And then ensure that within the 3 months of brooding, all your chicks are vaccinated properly with the right vaccines. Taking care of them until they start laying eggs is also into the brooding, because you brood from day one, almost like 3 months, and then you take them from the brooder to the growing area. You have to ensure that they are fed well with proper feed. Buy your feed from the proper people, from the proper suppliers, because sometimes feed is high, the feed is put is manipulated, and you find that we end up feeding our chicks with the wrong feed, which affects laying in the later stages.
Nantambi, who runs a farm with 4,000 birds, comprising 2,000 laying and 2,000 not laying birds, efficiently manages her operations. Today, she successfully harvested 56 trays of eggs, which she sells at 10,000 shillings per tray. During our conversation, she shared her strategies for navigating the dynamic market conditions to achieve her desired profits from the farm.
The ones that are laying, the 2,000 ones, I pick 56 per day. The cost ranges between 10,000 and 12, depending on your market. Now, like ours, we have hotels, we sell to hotels, we sell to wholesalers, we sell to retailers, and the individuals who come.
On the farm, various methods of generating income exist. For instance, Nantambi Christine has found a unique way to make money by selling chicken droppings to other stakeholders, such as those in the piggery and fishing sectors. This additional profit contributes to the overall profitability of the farm.
Droppings, yes, the chicken droppings, we have different types of droppings here. We have the one of cages, which is dried. The cage, you know, as I mentioned earlier on, the cage has challenges. Its dropping don't dry. So what happens? We dry it using the manure watering machine, and that dried component is like feed itself. So it is used to feed other animals, like pigs or fish. So some people who do that type of farming come and pick it. Then we also take the droppings from cages into the biogas. The manure from the biogas is purely 100% very good, because all gases have been removed. It goes to the gardens. They are those ones who want it.
In addition to selling chicken droppings, Nantambi implemented the construction of biogas at her farm. This innovative approach could offer an excellent solution to address some of the farm's cost, particularly the issue of powering the farm. If adopted by other farmers, this idea has the potential to significantly boost profits derived from poultry farming.
The biogas, we use the droppings, the raw droppings from the cages, and then we mix it to go into the digester. In the digesters, gas is produced. This gas is used for cooking. Here we don't use, we use biogas for cooking. Then the residue from the digester is the one that is sold to other farmers. We dry it and then we put it in a bag and then we sell it at 10,000.
Nantambi, who also rears rabbits on her farm, guided us around the premises. During the tour, we inquired about her decision to incorporate rabbits into her farm.
Chicken and the rabbits are almost in the same family. So we also went into the rabbit. Like I said, we are working with other farmers who are in rabbits. So we started also the rabbitry to supplement the meat that we get from farmers, which we use into processing. So we do the rabbits and we do rabbit meat. We do rabbit roasting for individuals. A kilo of roasted meat, a kilo of roasted rabbit costs 20. A kilo of rabbit meat parts, we sell it at 25. 500 grams of rabbit sausages, we sell it at 18.
Farmers often contemplate whether their agricultural ventures are genuinely profitable or merely a means of safeguarding their money outside the banking system. Maintaining precise and current farm records is a crucial aspect of farming. These records should encompass all activities taking place on the farm. During our interview with Nantambi, we sought to understand her approach to keeping farm records.
I do keep records. I even have I have a quick book. I have Excel. I have hard books. I do use quick book. I have audited books annual, because the audit books are supposed to be annual.
Inquiring about the required labor and the compensation for caring for 4,000 birds, we spoke with Nantambi to determine the number of farmers she employs on her farm to take care of the chickens and their monthly remuneration.
I have 5 workers.
How much do you pay?
Our payment ranges between 150 and 800.
We attempted to ascertain whether the family is actively involved in the day-to-day operations of the farm and the extent of their contributions to its activities.
Family is inclusive. When my kids are around, I encourage them to be here. My husband is in the rabbits. Yeah, the family is inclusive.
Farming is often perceived as a profession for retirement, where individuals take it up after leaving their primary careers. However, Nantambi breaks this stereotype as she continues to work in another job while pursuing farming. We investigated how she manages both roles effectively, ensuring she doesn't incur losses in either field. Additionally, we explored her reasons for not opting to retire before venturing into farming, unlike others who typically do so.
Still employed somewhere. People always ask me that question, why I still get employed. One, I'm laying a foundation for my retirement. I'm retiring very soon. And people make a mistake. They start working when they've retired. Others, they don't plan their retirement very well. And when they start work at the later stage, they just fall down without a base. But me, I've developed something in process. So by the time I retire, which is soon, I have where to fall to continue.
What are some of the challenges confronting Nantambi on her farm?
The main challenges is finances to expand your dream where you want it to be, that is one. Two is our market. As I said, our products are determined by the market, especially the eggs. The feeds, the main challenge in the chicken is feeding them. The cost of feeding is very high. And it keeps changing now and then. As it changes, the cost of an egg doesn't in the market. The price of an egg in the market remains a constant, which sometimes hits us hard.
What is the farm's contribution to the community that is living around it? And has it been any important to the people around it?
I won't use neighbors, I'll use community. Because the neighbors are part of the community. They've also improved their life, their livelihood, how they live their life, because we've offered jobs to them. Casually, others have also got jobs through different channels. The truck drivers, the people who, the retailers. You find that somehow we have an impact on every person and they earn some income through us.
After conducting a comprehensive interview with Nantambi, we endeavored to understand her perspective on the poultry farm she manages today, which has proven to be a lucrative venture. During the interview, she openly shared her thoughts and insights on poultry farming and also provided us with her vision for the future of this industry.
My feeling, I feel I'm where I want to be. It is something I enjoy. I enjoy it. I feel I'm too excited to be a woman where I am, into all these things. Something I work with love, something I work with passion, something where I can get money with my head. I think I feel happy. I don't know how I can express it.
Poultry farming in Uganda presents both lucrative opportunities and risks, particularly for those lacking proper management knowledge. The industry significantly contributes to the country's economy, driven by high domestic and international demand for poultry products. As a result, commercial poultry farming is experiencing a surge in popularity thanks to the substantial profits it offers. Successful management of chickens is crucial for the prosperity of the business, encompassing aspects such as feeding, housing, and vaccination. Nantambi's exemplary practices, showcased in today's Harvest Money Show, provides valuable insights into effective poultry management That is it for the Harvest Money Show. Until next time, goodbye.